from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2350, week number of the month. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question sent in via YouTube from Foxy the Pirate Fox. What formula will determine a week just within the month? I love this question. I've never seen this one, but we want to number each week within the month, so from 1 to 5. And while I came up with an answer really quickly, I'm not sure exactly how we're going to number the weeks. There's two different ways that I can see. So is it that we start the week number on Monday? So here in July 2027, where the first of the month starts on a Thursday, this four-day week becomes week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4, and then week 5 is whatever is left. That was my first reaction. Or do you mean that if the month starts on Thursday, then everything from Thursday to Wednesday is week 1, and then week 2, and then week 3, and then week 4, and then week 5. So I'm going to solve it both ways. All right, the first way to solve it, where the weeks start basically Monday and run through Sunday. The first thing I want to know is, from these dates over here, what's the week number, the ISO week number? That tells me the week of the year. And then to get back to the first of the month. So that's, you know, for today, like on July 13th, it's week number 28. To get back to the first of the month, we're taking the end of month of that day and going back to the previous month. So always going back to June 30th, 2027, and then adding 1 to get to July 1st. Once we know the week, or the first of the month, we get the week number of that. All right, so here, the current day, the week number is 26. Here, the week number of the first month is 26. But later, you know, this is week 30 and this is week 26. And then to get to the week of the month, we just subtract B2 minus D2 and add 1 because it's never week 0. And just wrapping that whole thing together, the ISO week number of your date minus the ISO week number of the end of the month of the previous month plus 1, and then add 1 so that way you never have a week 0. And I felt really good about this until I went to the next month. So I just kind of scrolled through here to check, right? We go up to week 5. August starts on a Sunday, so you have a one-day week 1, and that, I realized that we're going to be in trouble because you're going to have a week 6, and Foxy says, hey, it should only show 5 weeks max, and the only way to only show 5 weeks max is we must want this second style here, all right? But the great news, that style is a much easier calculation. So we have our date, we ask for the day of the date, divide that by 7, B2 divided by 7, and then use the roundup function, roundup. Roundup to one or zero decimal places. And then that formula just simply becomes the roundup of the day of A2 divided by 7, comma 0. And we make sure that down here in August of 2027, it still ends up at week 5. So we pass the test. All right, I want to thank Foxy for sending that question in. And I'm going to ask you to subscribe. I'm trying to get better merchandise. This stuff down here, I'm not a fan of these shirts. There's a company that has much better shirts, higher quality shirts, but they say you need 100,000 subscribers, and I'm currently in the low 90,000s. So please subscribe. Don't even ring the bell, right? I don't want to bother you. I don't want notifications on your phone. Just subscribe so we can have better shirts, please. Mr. Excel 2020, seeing Excel clearly. Click that I up there in the top right-hand corner for more information about that book. Well, I want to thank Foxy for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Tips and tricks, get your spreadsheet fixed at MrExcel.com.